Familiarity with the terminology used to describe location and relationships within the nervous system is critical as we move forward into examining brain systems. Directional terms are used to locate one structure, usually in relation to another structure. Anterior means in front of, which would be toward the face, whereas posterior means behind, which would be toward the back. Superior means above, so toward the head. Inferior means below, so toward the feet. Medial means toward the middle or midline, and lateral means toward the edge. The remaining terms point in different directions, depending on if they are referring to the axis of the brain or the axis of the spinal cord. The definitions in reference to the axis of the brain will be shown in orange arrows. The definitions in reference to the axis of the spinal cord will be shown in blue arrows. Dorsal means towards the top of the brain or the back of the spinal cord. Ventral means toward the bottom of the brain or the front of the spinal cord. Rostral means toward the front of the brain or the top of the spinal cord. And caudal means toward the back of the brain or the bottom of the spinal cord. There are planes or axes that can be used to examine the nervous system. The frontal or coronal plane is a vertical plane in a medial to lateral direction. It runs parallel to the eyes or ears, dividing objects into front and back pieces. The sagittal plane is also a vertical plane, but in a rostral caudal direction. It runs perpendicular to the eyes or the ears and divides objects into right and left regions. Finally, the horizontal plane runs parallel to the ground and will divide objects into top and bottom regions. The nervous system is divided into two primary components. The central nervous system, or CNS, is comprised of the brain and the spinal cord. The peripheral nervous system, or PNS, is comprised of the cranial and spinal nerves. When information flow is described in the nervous system, it can either be afferent communication, meaning it is moving from the periphery to the central nervous system, or efferent communication, meaning it is moving from the central nervous system to the periphery. Tissue in the central nervous system can be further divided into either white matter or gray matter. White matter regions are comprised of axons. It appears white due to the myelin sheath on the axons. Gray matter regions are comprised of cell bodies and dendrites. Gray matter is the location of most synapses. In the brain, the surface of the cerebral cortex is a layer of gray matter. White matter can be found below the gray matter layer and is the location of the axons traveling to and from the cortical cell layer. Gray matter can also be found deep in the brain in subcortical regions that play critical roles in behavior.